like to welcome you, those just joining us here for the start of the guys game. Those of you that are just joining us, we are here at campus of Maranatha Baptist University, and men's SaberCats team is going to be taking on the Eagles at Faith Baptist Bible College. It is Parents Day here. Got a big crowd on hand. If you were with us before, you got to see the SaberCats women's soccer team take care of business 8-0 against the Eagles of Faith Baptist Bible College. So we saw the girls, now we're going to see the guys duke it out. As the Eagles control here and they get it back to their back line. Eagles come in with a record of 5-5-2. As the SaberCats come in with a record of 2-7-1.
Track back quickly, Joey. Quickly.
SaberCats have played very well, even though they haven't been getting the win in some other games. They've played very well on the season. Played some really tough teams and played them really, really well. They are happy with where they are at. Not necessarily the record, but they are happy where they are at. Played some really good soccer here.
This
part of the season. Austin Angelo is going to pop that ball up and off of Caleb Sturgis, and it's going to go out of bounds for the SaberCats. Weirwama back on the field for the SaberCats. We were talking right before I turned the microphone on. He gets a big cheer from the crowd when they announce his name in starting lineups. He is a crowd favorite. David Levy, the junior keeper for the Eagles, is going to have a goal kick here. He gets it out deep. Josh Bray is able to settle that one down and get it to the back line. As Joseph Freericks is going to have the ball on his foot right here.
Hey, bring the energy. Let's go, boys. Yeah, yours.
Sturgis has the ball on his foot here.
Keep it here, Black. Keep it here. Keep it here.
Lancer with the ball, had it on his foot. Everyone is going to have the ball. Trying to move on the defenders, but is going to go out of bounds. Throw it here for Felderman. Felderman able to tip that one along. Got it on to Clark. Kevin Risma put it out wide. Gets that ball over to Nathan Campbell. As Tyler Nelson's trying to make something happen on that far sideline. And now Kevin Arisma with his parents in attendance. I know for a fact they're here. And they were here to see big sister Audrey score two goals and have an assist. That big win the girls' team had. Dan Cole, one of the captains in that back line, the junior for the SaberCats, was able to clear that ball away for the SaberCats for the time being. Tyler Nelson is going to have a throw in on the far sideline for the SaberCats. Mr. St. Lawrence with the ball here, gets it over to Caleb Walters, but a little bit too far, and it's going to be controlled here by the Eagles. Phillips puts that one in deep to Sturgis. Danko able to pop that one up. Here, Walter able to settle that one down.
Contain it.
Gets it up for Nathan Akers.
Stay with 12. Until somebody passes it.
Nathan Akers nursing a hamstring injury. Keeps giving him problems, but he gets the start here. So something to watch. Looked like he could go full speed and sprint on that one. That was going to be out on Sturgis again. And Austin DeAngelo is going to put that one in and return right back to him. Mesa St. Lawrence now on to Kim Walters. Good ball there. A little give and go between Tyler Nelson and Kevin Risma, excuse me. Dan Carroll had the ball roll right under his foot. Sturgis with the ball here. Sturgis is a big guy. Muscling. Muscling D'Angelo off the ball.
Yes! Good idea.
Mark up, say his weight on here, but he is a big guy. If he wanted to throw some weight around, he would most certainly do so. Derrick Roll's going to put it over on the other side of the field for Nathan Campbell. The way these two teams are playing, it looks like it's going to be a relatively even matchup here. That's going to be the size of the Sabercats, and or size of the Eagles, excuse me, and the speed of the Sabercats here in this game. Kevin Risma pops that one up into the air for Weir Wama. He's able to sail it down. You got to always watch when Weir has it on his foot. D'Angelo with the ball on his foot here, tried to get it in. That ball's going to go in on Levy. He's going to scoop it up right into his gut. He's going to punt it away here for the Eagles. Ball up into the air, not quite out of the Eagles' half yet. It was for a second, then returned right into the frames. Reconnoyer up ahead to Caleb Walters, now back to Ace St. Lawrence in the midfield. Once again, Kenora back to Austin D'Angelo. Nifty move there by the official to get out of the way of that ball. Now to Caleb Walters, cleared away by the Eagles. Out of the Sabercats' hat, or the Eagles' hat, excuse me. That's settled back down and given to Asa St. Lawrence. Asa with a great ball to Nathan Akers. You hate to see Nathan Akers go down like that with that hamstring injury, but he seems to be okay. Jumps right back up. Doesn't seem to be bothering him. It's nice and cool here on the campus of Maranatha Baptist University today. Really, really windy. So if you hear the rumble in the microphone, I apologize. I'll try and keep it out as much as I can. I say all that to say, you don't want Nathan Akers to tighten up. Breckenoyer tried to get a shot on, and that's going to go into the back of the net. And Breckenoyer is going to give the Sabercats an early 1-0 lead here on Parents Day in Watertown. That ball didn't have a whole lot on it, but it had enough to skip into the back of the net.
Bounce back!
Junior captain for the Sabercats, Brett Knoyer, has given them a 1-0 lead. He's trying to get his team pumped up. One shot on goal, one goal here for the Sabercats. I got a train coming right behind my back for those of you that have been here to the train. To the rumble. We'll be back here in just a second. 1-0 lead for the Sabercats. Yeah. cares? Sam has to put another one on the board. As Kevin Risway here on Parents Day. His parents, like I said, they are in attendance along with his younger brother Jack and older sister Audrey over on the sideline. They got to see Kevin put one in the back of the net. Kevin plays 100 miles an hour at anything that he's doing. And on the corner kick, he is able to put the rebound back into the net for a 2-0 advantage here for the Sabercats. Great move there put on by Caleb Walters. Weir Wama's going to have a chance to put on the brakes. Not quite going to be able to hit that ball at the end. Austin D'Angelo is going to settle it down, get it over to Kevin Grisman. Walters puts one on. It's going to go right by the post. We still got 34 minutes and 50 seconds left here in the first half, here in the early going in this game. And the Sabercats have had quite the offensive efficiency here in this game, as they have two shots on goal and both of them. Ball's going to go up into the crowd. And it's going to be a throw in for the Sabercats on the far sideline. Kevin Rizzo with the ball on his foot here. I have to say a little roommate pride there. That is my roommate who put one in the back of the net. Field that he needed to score a goal, so I can bring him on here. And it figures that the train would be going by, but again. But congratulations to him. So that train is finally passed. He would be able to carry a little bit better. Josh Green chips that one in deep here for the Eagles, controlled by the Sabercats, however, as St. Lawrence settles it down and gets it over to Caleb Walters. The ball chipped in a little bit deeper, but now over to Nathan Campbell. Tyler Nelson gets the ball returned to him. Physical play muscles that defender off the ball. Throw in here for the Sabercats as Kevin Risman tries to chase that one down, but it's popped up into the air and controlled by the Eagles. Fredericks with the ball, he puts it in. And Andy Taylor's going to try. He comes out and makes a great save. That ball almost got by him, but he stuck his hand up in the air, got his mitt on it, and knocks that ball away. A great game overall being played here by the Sabercats, and hopefully it continues here on Senior Day. Weir with a little bit of dancing in the middle of the field, finally gets it back to Ace of St. Lawrence and chips it in deep. As Nathan Akers is going to come away with this ball here on the sideline. He gets it over to Austin D'Angelo, now back into the middle of the field. And Weir Wama with the ball in his foot. And you can see a lot of attention being paid to Weir in the middle of the field. And I don't blame him. It's a scary place to be for opposing teams when Weir gets the ball on his foot in the middle of the field with a little bit of space. Caleb Walters was going to try and square one up there. Now gets it in for Nathan Akers. Chipped up into the air. Sturgill trying to get that ball. And the ball put onto Brett Knoyer and now into the middle of the field. And Caleb Walters now, puts one by. Tried to get across there in. It looked like Kevin Risma again, but it went a little bit too far past the post. And it's going to be a goal kick here for the Eagles. Levy not going to be the one to take this. That was Wesley Schultz putting that ball into play here for the Eagles. Not sure if Levy will really take any goal kicks here in this game. Weir Wama with the ball in his foot, gets it in to Brett Knoyer, trying to square one up, can't get it, tried to leave it off from Nathan Akers, but couldn't get him one. As Ace of St. Lawrence puts it back in, still controlled partially here by the Eagles. Now the Sabercats are going to have possession here of this ball as Austin D'Angelo tries to put it into the middle of the field, and Sturgill has the ball. Dan Kroll puts it back in to the Eagles zone. And Levy comes out, picks it up, and he's going to punt it away here for the Eagles. Something to watch if Levy will take any of his goal kicks here. That punt was straight up in the air. It looked like it got hung up in the wind, but I'm looking at a flag, and there's no wind. So that ball just went straight up in the air on Levy. If you've watched Sabercats games before, Andy Taylor doesn't take a whole lot of his kicks either. That ball put a shot on goal here for Weirawama. Didn't get it quite as much on it as he wanted to. That's going to be the third shot on goal. And finally, a shot on goal doesn't go in the back of the net for the Sabercats as Levy makes the stop. As I was saying, Andy Taylor doesn't take a whole lot of his goal kicks for the Sabercats either, as it's normally Nathan Campbell or Austin D'Angelo go and take the kick for Andy Taylor, and it looks like it's the same kind of situation with Levy, as Schultz would have to take that goal kick earlier. And we'll see how that plays out. Nathan Akers with the ball on his foot here. Ball chipped up in the air. Akers is going to settle that one down one more time. Get it back to Austin D'Angelo, and now over to Dan Grohl. Dan Grohl puts it over to Tyler Nelson, and now to Nathan Campbell. Schumacher was trying to get possession of that ball for the Eagles, but the Eagles aren't able to possess this ball a whole lot here in the early going of this game. As soon as I say that, Fredericks with the ball on his foot here. Asa St. Lawrence comes away with possession, gets it back to Campbell, and now over to Dan Kroll. Dan Kroll, another one of the captains here for the Sabercats in that back line. Now Sturgeon is going to have a shot on goal here. He puts it up and over the crossbar. Andy Taylor was on his toes back there, but I'm not exactly sure he's going to get to that ball. It goes up and over the crossbar. Luckily here for the Sabercats, 28 minutes. It's a change left here in the first half, as this is going to be Campbell taking the goal kick, like I said, here for Andy Taylor. Andy Taylor, not with the biggest leg on the team, but he is extremely athletic and quick in goal for the Sabercats, and he's done a really great job since stepping into the starting keeper job for the Sabercats here this season. I believe Andy Taylor played his freshman year for the Sabercats. He was backing up who was then the goaltender Charlie Leeds, has since graduated for the Sabercats. Andy didn't play those next 2 years, and here he is playing for the Sabercats. As he is still technically, I believe, a junior. I'm looking on the roster. He's listed as a senior here on the... The ball's going to be in the back of the net once again by the Sabercats. It's Tyler Nelson, the newcomer, the freshman. He's going to get one to go into the back of the net. Coach Jeff Pill praising his team for the assertive play that they're having here in the early goings. I said at the beginning of this, it looked like an even matchup, but it is anything but even on the scoreboard right now. The Sabercats have opened up a 3-0 lead here with still 27 minutes to go left in the first half of this game.
Sabercats goal scored by number 7, Tyler Nelson. Assisted by number 3, Austin D'Angelo.
Austin D'Angelo on the assist. Now the Tyler Nelson goal. As the ball is controlled here, as Ferris puts it back into play off Sturgill and now into the midfield and Schultz. Schultz gets it over to Glanzer. Glanzer trying to put a move on Asa St. Lawrence, but Asa's not having it. He drops it back. for saves that one, excuse me, from going out of bounds. And Asa St. Lawrence falls right on top of that ball. It's going to be a Sierra Crest ball, and Austin D'Angelo puts it back into play into a wide open middle of the field. The only person there except for Caleb Walters was the official, and the official's not allowed to play the ball. So he gets it to Caleb Walters. Physical play there. Caleb's not going to get the call. And he's going to pop right back up. Nice bicycle kick there from the Eagles player. Slide tackle put on there by Walters and Ace St. Lawrence. Campbell was once again back to put that ball back into play on the goal kick there by the Sabercats.
Track back, quick! Work for your team, let's see it! Pressure. Step on his foot.
Dick Roll puts it back in deep, but it's returned right back to the Sabercats half.
Here we go, whip ball here! Hit it here!
Roll, into the flag, Roll! They have two guys stacked centrally.
Two teams jockeying for possession of the ball here in the midfield. Caleb Walters with the ball on his foot here gets it over to Tyler Nelson. Tyler now gets it back over to Caleb Walters. Nice footwork by Caleb Walters. Caleb's known for really good footwork when he gets in a crowd of people on the field. Weir Owama with the ball on his foot here, trying to square up a shot, not going to get there. But another shot put on there by Tyler Nelson.
Inside of him.
And it went
inside,
just wide of the net.
Every time. Black. Daniel.
This looks exactly like the girls'
side.
Game as the Sabercats are putting all kinds of pressure on David Levy. Kevin Wilson taken down. And it's going to be a kick here for Nathan Akers. Is normally the one to take these kicks. To see if he does it here. He's lining it up right now. And it is not going to be Nathan Akers. It is going to be
Nathan.
Caleb Walters. Supercats getting set up. Official blows the whistle. Caleb Walters puts it in right over the top of the head of Nathan Akers.
Good work.
Go wide, wide, go wide.
Good call. Yeah, there you go, there you go. See, Sturgeon. He needs to hear from you.
Hey, talk.
Caleb Walters now settles that ball back down, but taken away. They're on a nice play by the Eagles. Jackson Clark was the one that was taken down. I believe that ball's going to come back out to midfield. It is. It's going to be a kick here for the Eagles. A little over 22 minutes left here in the first half of a 3-0 game in favor of the Sabercats. Sabercats have had four shots on goal, three of them found the back of the net, one corner. And the Eagles have had no goals, one shot on goal, and no corners so far.
Here we go.
This ball's in deep for the Eagles, trying to get a settled down. Glanzer has the ball. He tried to put a shot on, couldn't get it to go. Sturgill's trying to get the ball on his. Can't get it there. Sturgill puts it back out. And now Friedrichs with the ball. He puts one on and way up over everything. And also wide left.
Here we go.
And Taylor couldn't get a hand on it. The ball's going to go out of bounds for another goal kick here for Nathan Campbell. Kick Campbell puts it back in. AC St. Lawrence is trying to head that ball along, but missed. Now the ball's chipped up in the air. And Ace is able to, well, he was going to settle it down, but then he blew a tire, fell. Seems to be all right, though. He jumps right back up. Now Austin D'Angelo gets possession here of this ball. Mike McNair gets that ball a little bit deeper into the Eagles' half, trying to get possession of this ball. That ball looked like it went over the sideline, but apparently it didn't go all the way out. But Brett Canoy is now going to have to go off at him and throw in here for the Eagles. Dan Kroll alertly puts that ball back down the field for the Sabercats. That ball's going to hop up and over and almost to the foot of Wirawama. 20 minutes left here in the first half. Kevin Arisma is going to have a throw in on the far sideline. Goes right by Ace of St. Lawrence. Austin D'Angelo puts it into Caleb Walters. Caleb trying to get a little bit of space. Gets it to Nathan Akers. Nathan Akers shoots, and he's going to get one to go into the back of the net. Athletic play there by Nathan Akers. And once again, a little roommate pride as my other roommate's going to score this one. They're the fourth goal of this game. Great play there by Nathan Akers, and it's going to be, like I said, a 4-0 lead with a little over 19 minutes left here in the first half. That's the fifth shot on goal and the fourth one to go in the back of the net for the Sabercats. So they are, like I said, are very efficient here on offense.
Sabercats goal scored by number 15, Nathan Akers. Assisted by number 3, Austin D'Angelo, and number 4, Caleb Walters.
Walters and Austin D'Angelo are the ones going to get assists on that goal. Wirawama is going to have the ball in his foot here. Nobody wants to go get that ball. And Weir goes down. Hate to see that. Hopefully he'll be okay. Grab for that knee at first. Hopefully it's nothing serious. The official is going to go over and check. Weir is at least set up just a little bit, trying to shake it off. He's going to hop back up. A little bit of a limp. Let's see if he can walk it off. Doesn't look like he's going to be subbed for right now. Walking back over to the sideline of the Sabercats. Looks like he's might be okay, just comes all the way over to the sideline. Caleb Walters is going to set up this kick here. And as the Eagles complete the wall, Caleb Walters puts it right into that wall. It's knocked down. And Ace of St. Lawrence, he puts one on, and finally, control here by the Eagles, a save made, sixth shot on goal. Only the second one not to go in, saved by Levy. We're still on the side of the field trying to walk it off. Doesn't really come out of this game. Caleb Walters with the ball in his foot, gets it over to Wirawama. Weir being awful careful with that knee. Trying to get things all stretched out.
You know he's mishandling that.
Sabercats still able to possess this ball. As soon as I say something, of course, the ball goes out of bounds. It's going to be Eagles ball with a little over 17 minutes left here in the first half. The ball's popped up into the air. And Sturgis is able to settle that one down and get it back to Josh Bray. Saved there by Andy Taylor. Second shot on goal here for the Eagles. Big leg by Andy Taylor. Once again, not known for his leg and goal, but he got a hold of that one. He goes all the way down to the other end of the field. And now Kevin Rizma is going to get taken down. They get away with the call, however. Ray heads that one along as Sturgis is going to try and settle this one down. He's not going to be able to. The ball's going to be out of bounds on the Eagles and thrown in now, controlled by Asa St. Moore. And Stephen Thompson and Matt Sheely are going to be on the sideline, ready to check in here for the Sabercats. Asa St. Moore is using that speed to get back to that ball. Clears it away.
Use it.
Throw it in here by the Eagles once again. Into the middle of the field, they're going to try and put one in deep into the corner. Sturgis is going to get to this one, chips it back in, and away. Nice move by Austin D'Angelo. He's going to clear it away, but just chipped it along, got the defender in the air. He was able to clear it away, but however, Frerichs with the ball, and that's going to be a corner kick, I believe, for the Eagles here on this one. This is going to be the first corner kick of the game for Faith Baptist Bible College. Frerichs, I believe, is going to be the one to take this one in the corner. He chips it up and headed away by Brett Kanoyer in the middle of the box.
We're behind!
They'll chip in once again, cross, handled easily. Andy Taylor.
Here we go, Black.
He's going to look. You know, he throws it short to Tyler Nelson. Tyler's going to lose that ball. I believe it's still going to be Sabercats ball. Two goal scorers in this game, Nathan Akers and Kevin Rizma, are going to come have a seat. And like I said, Stephen Thompson, number 20, number 10, Matt Sheely, are going to come over to this, or into the game here for the Sabercats.
Win that brace! Let's go!
Bench was yelling at Josh Bray to win that ball. That's his, but not when Weir has got the ball. Weir easily clears that one away. Here's Stephen Thompson, has the ball on his foot, and now back out to midfield. It was cleared away by the Eagles, but not completely, as Dan Kroll has the ball on his foot. He puts one on goal, and it was not on goal. This is going to go wide left of post. Not a bad thought there by Dan Kroll. He was all by himself, so he put a shot on. It's going to be a goal kick here for David Levy.
Win ball. Come on,
Chase. Asa St. Lawrence with control of this ball here. Gets it over to Matt Sheely over on the other sideline.
Hey, give it up, Black. Let's go, Bray. Hey, no look down. No look down.
Shot can be put on there by Stephen Thompson. It's going to be controlled by Levy. Seventh shot on goal there for the Sabercats. And that ball once again popped up into the air. And Levy's kicking against the wind right now, and it is not going anywhere for him as that ball was up in the air and hung there.
Hey, Todd, stay goal side. Yeah, step on his touch.
Asa gets it over for Matt Sheely. Caleb Walters now with the ball, gets it over to Sheely one more time.
Oh, get wrecked. You work. Good job, Moore. Nice. There we go, there we go. Move. Nice. Thank you. Hey, come on, shoot. See him, see him.
Ball control here by the Eagles, trying to put some kind of offensive pressure on Andy Taylor. It's going to be a throw in on the far sideline for the Eagles as he throws it in to Orlock. Felberman with the ball off his foot here, tries to get around Brett Kinnoyer and does, tried to connect there once again. Couldn't get it there. Cross into the box there, cleared away by the Sabercats. Danger area there. Caleb Walters is going to have the ball on his foot here. Gets it out wide. Not quite going to get there, is it? I believe that was Matthew that intercepted that ball. Eagles win this ball here. It is alertly cleared away and way down the field by Dan Kroll.
No one's coming. You're good. You're good.
You're 50 now.
Get that. Get on. Yes. See it. Yeah. Hey, hey. You want to say something? Oh, yeah.
On your back. Oh, I'm going to settle that one down.
Yes. Hold on.
Puts it back into the middle of the field. Makes it St. Lawrence is there to calmly get it to the junior captain, Brett Kinnoyer. Weary gets it up ahead to Stephen Thompson.
Stay goal side.
Stephen trying to get around the defense here, and he is roughly taken down. It's going to be a corner kick here.
Here we go, guys.
The Sabercats. Stephen's not the biggest of guys, but he got thrown away from the ball there by the defense. And they got away with it because the ball's going to go over the end line once again. Going to be a corner kick here for the second one of the game here for the Sabercats. Caleb Walters put that one in, and it was up and over everything. It's going to go over the end line, and it is going to be a goal kick here.
Here we go, Black.
For the Eagles.
Here we go. Turn.
Off the head of Orlov in the middle of the field. And Matt Sheely able to chip that one back in. Once again, fancy footwork there from Caleb Walters. Gets it to Austin D'Angelo, now to Ace of St. Lawrence. Ace has got a little bit of room. He's going to take whatever they give him. He's going to put a shot on. And didn't have a whole lot on it, but it went in on Levy. And he was unable to handle it. Bounced up, popped him in the chin. Sturgis is able to settle that one down. Now Bray has the ball on his foot here. Over into the middle of the field. And Freericks trying to get it to Orlov. I would imagine that's going to be a call. And it is.
Great ball, Joseph.
Dan Kroll, again, not the biggest guy in the world. Got hit checked there by Orlov. And that's the wrong game. That's hockey. Ball's going to be put back into play here by the Sabercats, and Matt Sheely is going to have the ball on his foot. Able to muscle his defender off of the ball, gets it over to Caleb Walters. Caleb trying to put a move on the defense there, couldn't quite get a pass. It's going to be controlled here momentarily by the Eagles, but given right back to the Sabercats on a throw in on the far sideline. going to have Sabercats player down. I believe that is Caleb Walters over on the other side of the field. He's got a little bit of a limp when he gets up. Andrew Young is going to check into the game here for the Eagles of Faith Baptist Bible College. At number 22, Caleb Schumacher is going to be the one to come have a seat. Caleb Walters trying to walk it off. He's still got very, very ginger
limp. The Eagles, 21, Andrew Young.
Caleb Hakama is going to come in here and get some time. Checking here for the Caleb Hakama. He's going to come off the field here. He's walking around the backside of the field out of bounds. He has been checked out of this game. Let's see if it's, hopefully it's nothing serious as the injury there.
Step right back on it.
Sabercats have been ridden with injuries anyway. Just little nagging ones, not anything to keep anybody out.
Sturgis with 19.
Steven Thompson is going to lose control of that ball over the end line. Going to be a goal kick here for the Eagles.
It's okay, Bryce. Remember your man.
Trainer here at NBU went over to talk to Caleb Walters, and Caleb motioned over that he was okay, just needed to walk it off. Now he's sitting at the end of the bench, giving himself a rest. Hopefully he'll be okay. Dan Kroll, back to the action, has the ball on his foot here, and now over to Tyler Nelson. Tyler Nelson and Caleb Hakama switch places. Opposite sides of the field. Tyler's over here on this side. Now Caleb Hakama takes his spot over on the other side of the field.
As Caleb's
more used to playing on the other side of the field. And he's got the ball on his foot here, trying to use that speed. Caleb can fly. He's got some speed. He puts it in on Levy. And he takes it right into the gut. He is going to come short here on this side of the field for Willie Felderman. Felderman being watched by Brett Knoyer. Now Freerix is going to put this one into this half of the field. Dan Kroll trying to get possession of this ball. Now it's back on Bray. Bray gets around Kroll. Now he gets around another defender and a ball in on Andy Taylor. And Andy slides, makes the catch.
Here we go.
Good job of tracking down that ball and staying with it was Andy Taylor. And once again, a big putt by Andy Taylor. I don't know what it's got into Andy today, but whatever it is, he's got some distance on his punts. He's kicking with the wind. That might help a little bit. This ball's chipped in. And it's going to be a corner kick here for the Sabercats.
Here we go, Black. Here we go.
Hey, no let down.
I believe
go,
that was Joey Young with a very gutsy header back toward his goal. Luckily, up and over the crossbar. It's going to be a corner here for the Sabercats. Third corner of this game, Weir is going to come off the field here. He's going to take a seat. Still got a little bit of a limp. Andrew Ice is going to check into the game for the Sabercats. Brecken Oyer is going to come out and play midfielder because Weir came off the field. Stephen Thompson tried to make an athletic play there. Couldn't quite get there. Andrew Ice, the freshman, is going to come into the game here.
Here we go, come
on, boys. Buck 55 left here in the first half here of this one. Tyler Nelson had that ball get right or by him, excuse me. And the bench of the Eagles exploded. Thinking that they had a chance at a goal there, but not so much. As Tyler Nelson comes back away with possession of this ball here. Gets it into Andrew Ice, but Sturgis takes that one away back into the middle of the field, but once again, taken away by the Sabercats and Brett Knoyer. Brett tried to chip that one in, couldn't get it to go. It was deflected down by the Eagles. That ball's going to go out of bounds and make contact with that minivan over there. And it is going to be a throw-in on the far side of the field with 1:10 left here in the first half. Austin D'Angelo is going to drop it back to Dan Kroll. Dan Kroll tried to get it to Brett Knoyer. Couldn't quite get it there. The ball's chipped up into the air. Nathan Campbell's going to have that one go out on him. He's going to let it go out of bounds and throw in on the far sideline for the Eagles at Faith Baptist Bible College. Ball taken away here by the Sabercats, and it's going to be cleared down deep. Got a Sabercats player down. Is that, I believe, is Caleb Hakama. And he had to have gotten the wind knocked out of him because he got popped. Two players exchange high fives. Everything looks to be okay. Hawkins is going to try and run that one off a little bit, but he, I'm telling you, got popped in the middle of the field on a physical play by the Eagles. We only have 19 seconds left here in this one. I got to try and kill him behind me. I'm trying to shield it, and there's no reason to turn the mic off right now. Sabercats trying to come away with possession of this ball. It's Matt Sheely is going to have the ball here, trying to get it to Andrew Ice. It was taken away by the defense of the Eagles, and not cleared out completely. And this ball is going to be. Train come by right at kickoff. So it is gone now. We'll reset the game for you. Sabercats in the first half dominated on offense. They had 3 corner kicks, 8 shots on goal, 4 of them found the back of the net. And for the visiting Eagles of Faith Baptist Bible College, they had 1 corner kick, 3 shots on goal. And Andy Taylor, the keeper for Maranatha, has got a shutout going right now. Nathan Akers back into the game, goal scorer in the first half. That was Steven Thompson trying to get around on the other side. This is going to be a corner kick here for the Sabercats. This is their 4th corner kick of the game. So Nathan Akers is going to be the one to take this corner for the Sabercats. Ball put in partially cleared away here by the Eagles, but not completely as Tyler Nelson has the ball. It's now got it over. I believe that was Austin D'Angelo. Now Caleb Hockema is trying to get that ball into the zone. Once again, Tyler Nelson gets it into the middle of the field, and Austin D'Angelo now over to Ace of St. Lawrence. Caleb Hockema able to settle that one down over to the near side of the field, and Nathan Campbell. Nathan Campbell between the legs to...
Inside, Daniel. Stay with eight, Daniel.
Kevin Arisma. Kevin trying to get around that defender. He's going to be muscled off the ball. And Easton St. Lawrence pops it up into the air. A little bit too far from Nathan Akers. Stephen Thompson was trying to run that one down, however, not going to be able to get there. Great play by Dan Kroll to step up, get that ball. He didn't have any help behind him on defense. Lanzer was trying to come in all by himself on goal. Caleb Hockler with a great ball across, trying to get that to Brett Kinnoyer. Didn't quite get there, however. Faith player was down for a second. Frericks. Schumacher gets it knocked away here by Campbell and taken away back by Gray, and now over to Lanzer. Austin D'Angelo with the ball on his foot here. Gets it back to Nelson, and now up ahead to, I believe that was Nathan Akers.
Good job, Sturgey!
Tyler Nelson going to take the kick here for the Sabercats. Puts it back into play up and over Nathan Akers' head.
There we go. That's yours, Sturgey.
Akers here going to be able to settle it down.
Hey, high second, that's your ball.
Has a defender all over him. Step all over to Austin D'Angelo, and Ace St. Lawrence takes a tumble, but he's able to get back on the ball. Physical play by the Eagles. It's going to be rewarded to the Sabercats here.
Cole, that's what we needed. That's good. That's all right. Keep working. Pick up
your team. Energy, Black. Get it back. Get it back.
Nathan Akers scored a goal in that first half, and he's going to take the kick here for the Sabercats. Puts it in deep. Headed away momentarily by the Eagles. Brett Kinnoyer tried to square that one up. Up off the top of his foot. It's going to be a goal kick here for the Eagles. Wes Schultz going to be taking the kick here. Actually, that was Frericks that took that one. Schultz took it for Levy in the first half.
Good hustle, Caleb. Good hustle.
Going to be out of bounds and throw in here for the Eagles on the near sideline. Bray with a great throw into the middle of the field. Glanzo trying to get possession of this ball. Pops it up in the air. Attempted a bicycle kick. Goes big. And then it's going to be a goal kick here for Eddie Taylor. I would imagine Nathan Campbell is going to take this goal kick here for the Sabercats.
First ball, let's win this.
Set the pace, set the tone. Winner,
Paul.
Yeah, step.
Tyler Nelson gets the ball taken away from him there. Dan Kroll can't quite get it either.
Here we go.
Nathan Campbell puts that ball up and out of play. Clark's going to go over to throw this one in for the Eagles. Gets a ton on that throw. Crossed in there right into the hands.
I think it was a cross, but I think it was also a goal.
Andy Taylor's not going to be coming against the wind. He had a couple of huge punts in that first half. He was kicking with the wind.
Yes, Willie.
And now he's going to be going against it. That ball kind of hung up in the air for a little while. Over to the near side of the field. Daniel Moore was trying to gain possession of that ball, put it in deep, and it's going to be taken by the Sabercats. As Frericks can't gain possession of that ball either. Nathan Akers with the ball on his foot. As Moore's trying to get possession, can't. Gets it back to Risma. And now over to Nathan Akers one more time. Nathan puts it in the middle of the field. Brett Knoyer settles it down. Brett trying to put a move on the defender here. Crosses it in and off the chest. And now Levy's going to pick that one up and put it away. Here for the Eagles. A little over 36 minutes left here in the second half. We are early on here in the second half here of this one. And it is 4-0 still in favor of the Sabercats of Maranatha Baptist University here on Parents' Day.
Hey, cut it down here! Keep it here!
Reckonware gets it into the middle of the field for Austin D'Angelo.
He's going.
Gets it to Kevin Risman, now out to Caleb Hockman. Caleb Hockman trying to use that speed.
Alright, Caleb, right back on him. That's your man. 19.
That's going to be a throw in here for Hockman. Hockman wants to get that throw. Levy's going to pick this one up. See if he punts it away. He's kicking with the wind. Acts like he's going to throw it. Now he's going to punt it. Gets it out to midfield, but not out of the Eagles' half quite yet. Now it's going to leave the side of the field as Dan Kroll is going to have it. Going to put it out of bounds. He's going to throw in on the far sideline for Sturgis and the Eagles. Chase Clark going to check into the game here. And number 15, Cole Glanzer, is going to come and have a seat. Eagles trying to gain possession of this ball, and Sturgis with the ball on his foot. Gets it into the middle of the field, taken away by Stephen Thompson. Stephen tried to chip one ahead to himself, but it got redirected by the defense of the Eagles. Ball put in, and it's going to go softly in on Andy Taylor. He's going to pick it up. Looking to punt this one away for the Sabercats. It's going to go as a shot on goal, but there wasn't a whole lot on that. Four shots on goal now here for the Eagles. None of them found the back of the net, as Andy Taylor still has shutout intact.
Yep, step block, step block.
Stop!
Andy Taylor puts it over to Nathan Campbell, and now up ahead to Caleb Hockman. Nice header. Here we go. Risma trying to get that over to Hockman, but it's going to go out of bounds. And Young is going to throw. Young's going to hand that ball to Kevin Risma because that was a throw in for the Sabercats. Now it's going to be a goal kick here. Taken by Frericks. Levy wanted to take that goal kick himself, but Frericks told him to back off. They'll take it himself. Kevin Risma is going to settle this ball down here for the Sabercats and get it out to Austin D'Angelo, and now up ahead to Brett Knoyer. Brett got help on both sides as Nathan Akers is there. He tries to square one up.
Way to recover.
His foot and way up and over everything. And it's going to be a goal kick here once again for Frericks.
Come
goal kick's going to go all the way to the back line of the Sabercats as Nathan Campbell gets it to Nathan Akers. Akers chips it up ahead, looking for break and runner, but Orlov has the ball on his foot now. Now gets it one more time, trying to get around the defense of Nathan Campbell. Great play there by Caleb Akala. Take that ball away. Caleb Akala came in.
Energy, black energy, everything you got. Look back.
Into this game when, I believe it was when Weir Lama got hurt. He is still on the sideline out of this game. Caleb Akala came in. He has played extremely well.
Good, Black, good. Good, Black, here
so
we go.
This game, Caleb Walters and Weir Lama have come out of this game with injuries.
Hold up.
For privacy and respect reasons, we can't tell you what the injuries are. We can't tell you that they're still out of the game. So now Stephen Thompson and Caleb Hakama are both getting quite a bit of playing time here. In this game, we got just over 31 minutes left here in the second half of a 4-0 game. Schumacher's going to check back in, as is Baldwin. And Bray's going to come have a seat, and Sturgis is also going to come have a seat for the Eagles of Faith.
That is Bible time. Number 9, Andrew Baldwin, and number 22, Caleb Schumacher.
Throwing on the far sideline for the Eagles. Chipped up into the air as Frerichs just about got to taste Nathan Akers' cleat on that play. Got his face out of the way just in time. Ball's going to be put in deep here and kicked up in the air by Dan Kroll. Orlov looking for that ball. Orlov. He had a ton of height on Kevin Risma, and Risma still got to the ball first. Ball's going to be in on Andy Taylor. He plays a short hop perfectly. A little over 30 minutes to go left here in regulation of a 4-0 game. And once again, I've got a train coming behind my back, so I'm not going to make you guys listen to the rumble, so I'm going to turn the mic off real quick and let you guys listen in silence to Sabercats men's soccer. Probably wasn't the most intelligent thing to say, but I was going to let you listen. I was going to let you watch it. But you're never allowed to be put on live stream while I'm
live. C's pretty good. You are definitely better.
I will give it to Faith. They are a very, very physical team. Andy Taylor throws the ball away from him. official is going to stop time here, and we're going to see how Taylor is. Wesley Schultz. There's a lot of college football going on around the country today, and I think Schultz should be trying out for one of those teams. That was a nice hit he laid on Andy Taylor. We're going to make sure Andy's all right. He's shaking out his wrist or his hand, so we're going to see if he's okay. Randall Larson is the backup keeper. Randall Larson is the backup keeper. He would be the one to come in and replace Taylor if he cannot go any further, but it looks like Taylor's going to put his glove back on. And with 27-35, he is going to stay in this game. Draws a cheer from the crowd and even the Faith Baptist Bible College bench. Good sportsmanship being shown by the guys in black.
Here we go, black. Here we go.
Even on the kick by Faith Baptist Bible College. Nice and easy put it in on Andy Taylor. He's going to punt this one away.
Let's go.
Nathan Campbell going to take this kick here for the Sabercats. He takes and chips it in. Trying to get to Nathan Akers. That ball hit a hand. I don't know how they got away with it, but the Eagles are actually not going to be able to get to that ball, and it's going to be a throw-in for the Sabre. Nope, going to be a throw-in for the Eagles on the far sideline. Nathan Campbell up in the air, heads that one down. The Eagles come away with possession of this ball. Danger area there, and it is partially cleared away there by the Sabercats. Ball chipped back up into the air, and Brett Knoyer is going to be the one to come away with possession of this ball off Nathan Akers, and now the Eagles regain possession. Shot put on Andy Taylor right into his gut.
Good energy. Everything you got, guys.
Another shot on goal put on by the Eagles. That is six shots on goal by Faith Baptist Bible College here in this game, and none of them have gone in the back of the net.
Hey, we gotta get the ball on the ground. We gotta go. Pressure,
Black, pressure. Ferris leaves it off. Aces and Lawrence is there. Now Kevin Risma settles this one down, gets it over to Nathan Akers. Akers is going to put this one on the other sideline for the captain, Brett Knoyer. Now back into the middle of the field, and Kevin Risma not going to be able to quite get there. And Nathan Akers is going to have the ball. He's going to put it up for Kevin Risma. Risma tried to put a sidestep on that defender. Couldn't quite get around him. Draws a little bit of a giggle here from the bench of the Sabercats. Risma already has a goal here in this game. Had it in the first half. Sturgis on the far sideline, able to gain possession of that ball. Now the Sabercats trying to chase it down. Tyler Nelson gets over to the corner. It's going to be out on Tyler Nelson. It's going to be a quarter for the Eagles. The third one of the game, I think, for them. Bray's going to come back into the game here. Number 9, Andrew Baldwin, is going to come out and have a seat for the Eagles. Corner kick put in to the box here. It is going to be Sabercats ball here. There was another Sabercat down. Can't quite tell who it is.
Caleb
Hakama is down on the ground. He is able to get back up. Looks like a hip maybe is bothering him. Caleb Hakama is taking a beating in this game. He is hanging tough, staying in this game. Sabercats really need him in this game right now with some of the injuries that have gone on here in this one. Faith is definitely a bigger team, bigger guys than the Sabercats have. Sabercats have taken some pretty decent hits in this game. Ball's going to get by Tyler Nelson. Ball chipped up. And now still up in the air. And now cleared away by Danny Kroll.
Here we go, Black. Here we go.
Much more pressure being put on here in the second half by the Eagles of Faith Baptist Bible College. Andy Taylor's going to come out for that one. Let's out a whimper like he doesn't want to be hit again. It draws a laugh from everybody that heard it. Bray. Josh Bray is a whole lot bigger guy than Andy Taylor was, and he was bearing down on Andy right there. And Andy didn't want any part of it. Got the ball and just absolutely cleared. Here's Kevin Rismel putting moves on the defender. He gets the ball taken away from him, and now Orlov has the ball on his foot, gets it in to Freerichs. Cleared back away by the Sabercats. Nathan Akers is going to settle this one down. He's going to chip it up ahead. Right, didn't have enough gas in the tank to chase that one down. So he's going to jog on. Gets a move put on him by the defense. Ball's going to be up ahead, and Tyler Nelson let an Eagles player get beyond him. Sabercats aren't playing quite as tight as they were in the first half, but still nothing on the board.
Keep your energy up, Black. Let's go. Let's finish this half.
Schumacher's going to come have a seat for the Eagles, and Sturgis is going to come back into the game.
Number 10, Matt Sheely.
Stephen Thompson is going to come have a seat for the Sabercats, as well as Matt Sheely. He's going to come in to replace him. While still in bounds, both teams fighting for possession. Ace of St. Lawrence able to clear it over the sideline instead of the in line. It's not going to be a corner, it's going to be a throw. Still popped up.
Offside.
It's going to be an offside call on Faith.
Keep it up, boys. You're doing great.
Keep up the work, Oleg. You're doing great.
Faith wanted a handball. And had that not been offside, they might have gotten it. Dan Kroll up into the air. And Austin DeAngelo settles that one down, gets it over to Ace of St. Lawrence, and now out to Caleb Hakama. Hakama puts it over on Brett Conoyer, now out of bounds. It should be, it's going to be a throw in for the Sabercats here on the near sideline. Caleb Hakama gets the ball in. Kevin Rismo with the on the near sideline tries to settle that ball down. And that ball's going to go up and over the train track.
All that turn.
Caleb Hakama with a throw back into the middle of the field, and Nathan Akers. As Frerichs puts that one up the field once again. Tyler Nelson trying to chase that ball down for the Sabercats. Does come away with possession. Good defense there by the freshman. Little over 18 minutes left here in regulation of a 4-0 game in favor of the Sabercats. Sabercats not playing as tight as they were in the first half, but still having a very good game. They've got the shutout intact. Brett Kamoyer is going to try and chase this ball down into the corner, and it's going to take a hop and out of bounds. It's going to throw it on the near sideline for number two, Jerry Young.
All right, energy, guys. Energy, Black. Here we go. Get after it. Get after it. Let's win it.
Cole Glanzer back into the game for the Eagles. And Chase Clark is going to come out.
Cole Glanzer and number 21, Andrew Young.
Nathan Akers chips that ball back to Asa St. Lawrence. Asa trying to not be muscled off that ball. Gets it over to Caleb Hakama. Now out to Brett Kanoyer. Brett might have been stepped on there. He comes up with a little bit of a whip. Bray's going to settle that one down, try and dribble into the middle of the field. Tyler Nelson is able to get that one over to Matt Sheely and out. Of danger.
Go, 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 no whistle.
Black here.
Here we go, Black. Let's put one in. Let's put one in.
Jackson Clark got tripped up there. And Frerichs is going to take this ball and get it over to Sturgis on the other side of the field, trying to get it into Glanzer. And Dan Kroll, showing the speed, gets it for the Sabercats, and now trying to get it up ahead to Brett Kanoyer. Matt Sheely with the throw in on the far sideline for the Sabercats, gets it in to Austin D'Angelo, and now back to Tyler Nelson. Asa St. Lawrence with the ball, middle of the field, gets it back to Dan Kroll, and now the Sabercats are going to switch fields. Austin D'Angelo now back to Asa St. Lawrence. Tyler Nelson trying to chase that ball down on the far sideline, is going to get there and able to possess that ball. Trapped along the sideline with a defender, gets it over to Nathan Akers. Nathan Akers to the middle of the field. And Austin D'Angelo was trying to square one up there, and it got knocked down. Ball's going to go out of bounds for another throw in on the far sideline for the Sabercats. Brett Kanoyer wrestles that ball away. And Matt Sheely puts the ball over the crossbar.
Yeah, here we go. Here we go.
And also wide right.
Hey, move!
Levy has been trying to take the goal kick this whole game, and his defender or his defensemen are not going to let him do so. John Zockel set to check into the game here for the Sabercats at the next opportunity.
Start it back up.
I don't think it's gonna.
What?
Guys, come behind. In the box. Put it in. Let's see. What's he going to have to do?
Take a hit again. The foul on Dan Quill, by the way, just outside the box.
Sorry about the technical difficulty there, folks. Didn't miss much. We got 13 minutes right on the dot left here in regulation of a 4-0 game in favor of the Sabercats. That foul was on Dan Kroll right outside the box. It's going to be a kick here for the Eagles of Faith Baptist Bible College. Ball put in there right up over the crossbar. And out. And it's going to be a goal kick here for Nathan Campbell, it looks like. Orlov coming back into the game, replacing Andrew Young. And also, Brett Knoyer is going to come out of this one here for the Sabercats. John Senior, or the junior, excuse me, had a goal here on Parents' Day, and John Zockel is going to come in for what I would imagine would be the next 12 minutes here of this game until this one's over. Nathan Eggers with the ball all alone in the middle of the field, gets it back over to the near side. And Caleb Hockley chips it back down. And Young had the ball at his foot, trying to get it past. Evan Rizma able to make Young put that ball out of bounds. He's going to have a throw in here on the near sideline. Evan Rizma always showing the hustle. He's also been nursing a sore ankle, and I think it aggravated him on that one. He looks like he should be okay. Now the ball back on his foot, and now chip up ahead to Asa St. Lawrence. But out of bounds, it's going to be a throw in here on the near sideline for the Eagles. Okay, we're trying to walk that one off.
Finish hard, boys. 10 minutes left. I want everything you got left. Let's go, boys.
Quick,
quick!
Use it!
Let's
mark!
Good stuff!
Let's pray! Let's pray! Pray, Whitney!
Josh Bray trying to settle this ball down, and one is going to get into the back of the net. And there goes the shutout for Andy Taylor as the Eagles bench went insane when that ball went in the back of the net. It is going to be a 4-1 lead. Here for the Sabercats, but the shutout is no more here on Parents' Day in Watertown, Wisconsin.
Here we go, Black. Here we go.
Good play there by Bray to get that ball past Andy Taylor. Andy Taylor was going to come out and meet him, and he chipped that ball right under Andy Taylor, and it was into the back of the net. So with 10 minutes right on the dot left here in the second half, we have a 4-1 lead in favor of the Sabercats. Joey Young was the one to put that ball up to Bray. He gets the assist on the play. Bray is actually leading the Eagles in goals. And if our stats are right, that is his 13th goal on the year. So a ton of goals.
First
for Josh Bray.
Yours, West. Go work,
watch
him.
Gotta hand it to Faith Baptist Bible College. They are fighting to the very end here in this game. Nathan Akers is going to try and put one. He put one on the near side of the field. And here at Maranatha, we've got new soccer goals, and the old ones are sitting over here on the sideline. I don't know if you can see them or not. You can see it in the screen right there. And Nathan Akers put one in the back of the net, but it wasn't the right one. So it is going to be all for naught, but it did, however, get a nice cheer and ovation from the SaberCats fans. Back to the action here. Nathan Akers trying to get possession of this ball, not going to be able to. Ball's going to go out of bounds. It's going to be a throw here for the... Nope. It'll be a free kick here for the SaberCats and Nathan Campbell.
Let's go, yellow.
Here we go, black. Ball headed up into the air. Controlled here by the Eagles. And now Sturgis is going to try and chase this ball down. Gets around Dan Kroll. Dan Kroll is going to try and chase him back down. And a great play by Austin DeAngelo to get that ball out of danger for at least a moment. As DeAngelo turns, tries to get that ball out, and he's going to, as Matt Sheely's going to have this ball, and he's going to put it out, and John Zockel's going to try and chase this one down. Couldn't quite get there. It's put up and into the Maranatha Baptist University fans.
Entering the game in goal for the SaberCats, number one, Randall Larson.
See there on your screen. Andy Taylor is going to come have a seat here for the last 6:36 here of this game. And Randall Larson is going to come in and have some playing time. Andy Taylor played a great game, only let that run in the back of the net. He had a lot of shots put on him. He has had 7 shots on goal. Only one of them he allowed in the back of the net. And he almost made a great save on the one that actually did go in. A great game played by Andy Taylor. Taylor Hockema also having a great game. Chases this ball back down. Out runs Orlov to the ball. Tried to get across in. Not going to get there. It's going to go over the in line.
Yes!
Go, Caleb!
Physical play going to reward the SaberCats ball. Here's Nathan Campbell, or Nathan Akers, excuse me, was going to get that ball in and off. The mark was, trying to see who that was. I think it was Asus Clarence. Ball was headed by in by Austin DeAngelo. And once again, Caleb Hockema with a great hustle play is going to get called for it though.
Energy, 5 minutes, let's go.
You gotta love the way that Caleb Hockema plays. He's 100 mile an hour all the time. He's really smart when he plays as well. Player gets behind. Gets behind the defense of the SaberCats, and the shot was put on goal, the 8th one of the game, and into the mitts. And a great save by Randall Larson. Nice play there by Matt Sheely to get the ball away from him through there. Oh, John Zocco with a move on the other sideline, trying to dribble his way in. Can't quite get there, but that was a nice move. All the fans over there, they're still going crazy. That was a nice move.
That's all right,
Hockey
back.
Caleb Hockey must put that one. Finish it! Eagles once again. Once again, Levy not allowed to take his own goal kick.
Go! Go, Levy!
Nathan Akers gets it over to Matt Shealy. Now back to Nathan Akers. He's going to chip it back to Tyler Nelson. Tyler's going to put the ball back into the middle of the field, and now Freericks with the ball here. He's going to put one on goal and right to Randall Larson. Larson's going to pick it up, put it away here for the Sabercats with 2 minutes and 50 seconds left here in this Parents' Day NCCAA North Region game.
Yes, Randall.
Win it. Punt there by Randall Larson. Austin DeAngelo got taken down on the play. It's going to be a kick here for the Sabercats.
All right, Black, lock it in, lock it in. Find your mark.
All right, you got 1 year
left. Joseph 11. Joseph 11.
Yes.
Get into the box, and Levy slides and makes the play. Wasn't really any danger, but Levy.
Girls game, guys game.
Go, Jay! Come on, Jay! Please!
Randall Larson comes out to make the save. I believe that was Chase Clark that slid for the ball, trying to get. Trying to get that ball in, I think he spiked Randall Larson. He did get a yellow card.
I'm not sure. But no. Yeah, clock keeps going.
He actually didn't get a yellow card, I don't think. Minute.
Yeah.
I'm being corrected. He actually did get a yellow card here in the late going of this game. We got a minute and some change left here in the regulation here of this game.
One more.
Play there by Young. He's not going to be able to track that one down. Good hustle there by Jackson Clark. Evan Rosemont with the ball in his foot. He's going to put across. It's going to go over. No, it's not either. It's going to stay in play. Now it's going to go over the sideline. It's going to be thrown here for Rizma. Oh, let me put it this way. Rizma tried to get away with it, but it's actually going to be thrown here for the Eagles. 30 seconds left here in this game. And with a three-goal lead, the Sabercats are going to come away with a victory here in this one. Horn's going to sound here at the Baptist University and the Sabercats.